There's two major portions of communication, and that's the speaking and the listening. And most of us as leaders, and I'm a professional speaker, get very comfortable with the talking portion. But during adversity and during crisis and during this road to recovery, every single one of us needs to get better at the listening portion. And we can't just listen, that's not enough. We have to actively listen. We have to truly care about cementing a stronger connection. We have to truly care and show that person how much they mean to us by giving them our full undivided attention. And it all starts with listening. The unconscious message you send when you listen to someone and you ask them insightful questions is that you care about them. And as I mentioned at the very beginning of this, caring matters, and it matters a lot. But I want to take communication to another level. It's so important that you realize that you need to communicate in a manner that is most receptive to the person receiving the message, not to you. When I was a child, you could take every kid and put them into one of two buckets. You had children that could swallow a Tylenol pill, and then you had children that had to have it smashed up in applesauce for them to swallow it. And I was actually one of the applesauce kids to an embarrassingly old age. But the reason I tell you that is I want you to think of that analogy every single time you're communicating, either with a client or customer, or with their colleague or coworker. I want you to think, how does this person take their Tylenol? Can I give it to them straight, or do I need to give it to them with a little bit of applesauce? Because it doesn't matter what you prefer. It doesn't matter how you take your Tylenol. As a leader, all that matters is how they prefer it and how they take it. And we have to be chameleon-like enough to give them their medicine in the way that they prefer, because that will be met with the least resistance and the most acceptance, and then we'll start to see behavior change, which ultimately is what we're trying to do with communication. We're trying to effectively convey our thoughts and our ideas and our standards so that we can cement our culture and see an improvement in performance. So it all starts with being able to find out where they are, go to their sandbox to play, and deliver messages in ways that are going to be most receptive to them. And if you can do that, if you can patch up all of the holes in communication, then it'll make sure that everyone on the team is swimming in the same direction and moving fluidly together.